The Bible says that the wind began to blow in that upper room, and we would call that a miracle. The miracle did not stop in the upper room, because the same wind that blew in the upper room kicked the door of the upper room open, and men stumbled out under the power of God, being accused of being drunk. They said among themselves, "We are not drunk as ye suppose, being it but the third hour of the day." But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel, that in the last day I will pour out my spirit upon your sons and daughters. Your old men will dream dreams, and your young men will see visions. And the wind did not stop blowing there. It blew in Acts 19 at a city called Ephesus, when believers who knew Jesus were filled with the power of the Holy Ghost. But it did not stop there. The wind blew in the second and the third century, and when human secularism and the blanket of religion tried to blow out the fire of God, men stood up under the power of God, and the wind continued to blow. It didn't stop there. At a meeting called the Cane Ridge Revival in the mountains of Kentucky, the glory of the Lord began to fall, and that wind began to blow again. But it didn't stop there. It went all the way to the Unicoi Mountains of Tennessee. And in 1896, at the Shear Schoolhouse Revival, that same wind began to blow that blew in the upper room, but it didn't stop there. At a place called the Azusa Street Revival, the wind of the Spirit began to blow and shook a nation, but it didn't stop there. Right now, in this hour, in this season, the wind that blew at Pentecost, praise God, it's blowing again, and it's blowing on the cities of the earth, so that men and women may come to a knowledge of Jesus. Somebody praise the Lord for the Holy Ghost.
I'm Kip Kip McBrien O. Williams.
And my name is Shirley Sassafras. I chew, bless you, consume tight, but you can call me Debbie.
Hello, Debbie. We are Wilderness Adventure, and this week we're out here in the wilderness to, you know what? I'm not being fair. Debbie here is pretty new, and I'll give her the chance to explain to you guys what we're doing this week.
Thanks, Kip. Well, I just wanted to tell you guys that we're out here on the outside in the wilderness exploring. And our first exploration thing we're going to be doing is we're going to try and plant a dollar. Because at our church, we are trying to raise $7 to send a box to Operation Christmas Child. But we can't get a job, and so we figured this would be easier. So we're going to plant
Debbie,
a money tree.
Debbie?
Money tree.
We have a visitor.
That was rude, Kip. You shouldn't have interrupted me.
I'm sorry, but she's hitting me with a stick. What is your name?
Woman of the Forest.
Her name is Woman of the Forest. What are you doing here?
What kind of name is that?
What are you doing here, Woman of the Forest?
I heard you wanted to plant money tree.
Yeah.
And I thought I'd come share you the story of the forest.
Story of the forest. Okay.
Have a
You want to hear a story?
Come closer.
There are ants on the ground. I don't want to see
them. I guess we're doing this now.
Come closer, Bruce.
Name is Chauncey, but okay.
There once was a money monster. Money grew on him and fell off whenever he was tickled. I think this is perfect for you to get your $7. Go free.
Where'd she go?
I think she flew away.
Okay, well, she's gone.
Like a bird.
What do you think we should do now, Debbie?
I think we should go hunt a money monster. Dun, dun, dun. Let's go.
Manamana. 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 Manamana.
We got it! We got it! We got it!
Kip! How do we get the money off
of him? I don't remember. How did she say to get the money?
I don't remember too much.
Oh no, we got him, but now we don't know what to do.
We won't have enough money for Operation Christmas Child.
What are we gonna do?
Operation Christmas Child?
You can't speak?
I love Operation Christmas Child. Have $7.
What? Yeah. Let me count this. 1, 5, 11, 12. 87! It's just enough!
Just enough!
87!
Yes!
Do you want a second count me?
No.
Okay.
Let's go!
$87. Thank you, money man!
You're welcome.
You guys, in all seriousness, please remember that this month is Money Month. So if you could donate $7 so we can send a box to a child in need for Operation Christmas Child, that would be great. This is Kip and Debbie signing off.
Money Monster.